定制的概念呢，最早起源于英国的萨维尔街。你看啊，它的单词有很多 ，personal made、customer made 或者是 tailor made， 但不管怎么样，它都是针对个人的。所以刚开始，定制呢只是精英阶层少数人拥有的一项服务。但是随着时代的发展，现在的定制呢越来越普及，而且种类也是越来越多。那现在，如果你要拥有一个非常个性的东西，而且只是属于你的，那么定制一定是一个最好的选择。
I would like to introduce myself, Giuseppe Picchiotti, as founder and president of Picchiotti, a family-run enterprise based in Valencia, Italy. I founded my company in 1967, but before that, I had a long experience as a jeweler working at the bench. I immediately fell in love with the world of jewelry making and became fascinated by the beauty and the precision of gemstones. I knew I was trapped, and that would be my life and my career.
Giuseppe Picchiotti 出生于一个医学世家。13岁那年，为了自己心中的珠宝梦想，他毅然决然地拒绝了家族为他规划好的职业安排，选择独自离家闯荡，学习制作珠宝的工匠技艺，终于成了一位出色的珠宝大师，并且如愿创立了自己的工坊，经营到今天。
So any story about this building?
Yes, well, this building is about 65 years old, and we bought it in 1977. Mm-hmm. So we have four such doors. Now, this is extremely safe, I would say, because it has a thickness of about 12 centimeters. It's extremely heavy, okay. So it looks, I mean, it's not very easy to enter here. Mm-hmm. Plus, we have a lot of alarm, as you see over there.You will have alarm everywhere. Every
每个角落都有警报。
Yes.
苍蝇都飞不进去。
Impossible.
Impossible. 哦，12英寸厚的门，确实很重。
Yes.
皮切奥蒂珠宝工坊所在的瓦伦扎市是意大利金饰工业最为集中的三大城市之一，诸多国际珠宝品牌都将自己的工坊建在这儿。而早在1840年，瓦伦扎市就开始了其艺术化精工设计产业的辉煌。直到今日，精工设计产业依然是这里的经济支柱，工匠、工艺、珠宝赋予了这个城市最独特的气质。
今天我们终于来到了 Picchiotti 的圣地哈。那你们一直坚持怎么样的技术呢？这样的技术有什么样的特别之处呢？
The secret is very simple.Is the passion that we at Picchiotti put into designing a piece of jewelry and creating it. It's the love for the special craft and the ability to have been employing over the years the best artisans and designers to have always met the highest expectations. It is Picchiotti's family that cherish and share every creative moment, and its very democratic method of brainstorming new ideas and freely voting for the best designs submitted to them by the company's team of designers.Okay, please come
okay.
in.
Okay, so this is your office?
Right, it is. Ooh. That's where I spend 99% of my time when I'm at home. This fireplace actually comes from the Venice area. This is another very important piece, in my opinion.
It's a two different two.
Absolutely, yes. Okay. Yes. This is from the 18th century, about 1770. Mm-hmm. And this comes from the Savoy family, which was the royal family of Italy.
Royal family.
Yes.
Wow.
This actually is also another piece which comes from the same royal family, the Savoy family. Oh. So from time to time, the queen was sitting here, mm-hmm. and her servants were taking her around. So okay. maybe one day my kids will transport me. I designed a table here, which is about 22 years old. It's nothing, mm-hmm. nothing sensational. I like the shape and I like the proportion. This is 2 meters by 1 meter, mm-hmm. and which I think is pretty interesting.
如今，皮切奥蒂先生已经年近八十，但出于对珠宝的热爱，他依然亲自把控设计和生产过程当中的每个细节和环节。为了搜寻各种稀有的宝石，他更是周游世界，这为皮切奥蒂带来了很多意外的收获，当然还有无穷的创作灵感。
This comes from actually from my mother's family. Mm-hmm.
Everything here is from your mother's family.
Yes, yes. 100% correct. Yeah, we have some awards that we got through the years. This is a Platinum Design Award, unique by Picchiotti. The best of show.
Best of show.
Yes.
Picchiotti 现在已经是业界领先、顶尖水平。那您怎么样来区分珠宝界的不同层次呢？
Picchiotti is definitely a leader in the field of high jewelry due to three fundamental factors: refined, exquisite design, superlative craftsmanship. The whole production process takes rigorously place in the Picchiotti premises under the strict supervision of the Picchiotti family. Now in the designing area, mm-hmm. the two ladies are our designers, and the mm-hmm. gentleman over there has been with us 44 years.
Wow. Yes.
This is a special ring. Mm-hmm. This is expandable. Mm-hmm. It means you put it into your finger, mm-hmm. and it opens and closes by itself. You put it on this finger.
Okay.
It's okay. You put it on this finger. It's also okay.
What's inside, can I?
That's a secret. That's a titanium.
I do.
Yes.
Sorry.
Don't worry. Keep it.
I have to keep it.
Okay, thank you.
作为彩色宝石的真正行家，在创作每一件珠宝时，皮切奥蒂都要求自己的团队在设计时不断完善，力求做到完美。因为设计是定制珠宝的第一步，其重要性不言而喻。在皮切奥蒂的眼中，他们要做的不只是一款珠宝首饰，而是一件美轮美奂的艺术品。
What's that?
Here there are about probably 4,100 different models. You just open it here. Mm-hmm. This is a ring, you see? This is the mold. And then we cast the wax in here. Mm-hmm. The wax goes through here. Uh-huh. Then it comes out and you have a ring here.
Okay.It's a diamond ring,
right?
A big diamond.
I'm going to show you afterwards, yes. But mm-hmm. to make a necklace, maybe we have 20, 30, 50, 60 such pieces in order to make one necklace. See?
Okay.
那么在您看来，定制珠宝的最大意义又是什么呢？
In my vision, haute couture jewelry never goes out of style. It transcends all fickle trends.That's why the design is classical and the pieces bear an intrinsic value due to the precious gems that they feature. They are considered heirlooms to be passed on to next generations.
皮切奥蒂在设计和工艺方面对于完美的不懈追求，让他如今拥有了大批忠实的追随者，从皇室贵族到明星名媛，都为他优雅的风格、顶尖的珠宝取材和无与伦比的精湛工艺而着迷。别走开，主角还将继续带您探访皮切奥蒂的珠宝工坊。
我是主角，你是谁？
意大利是一个历史悠久的珠宝工艺国度，在通常的情况下，这里的工匠大师们总能够同时精细地掌握不同材质的特性，在镶嵌上设计师精心挑选光彩夺目的各色宝石，最终设计制作出完美而独特的意大利珠宝。
The people you see here, they're all young people. Mm-hmm. So they have a great future.And the people actually started here when they were about, let's say, 16, 17, 18 years old. Mm-hmm. After they go into working a piece of gold, mm-hmm. it takes at least 6 years. So you have to be very patient and to wait some 5-6 years in order to go a little bit higher and be able then to piece, to make a piece in gold. Because at the beginning, they actually do not work gold, they work just brass, you know, just simple brass. But you have so many pieces to put together, you see. You see, this is very interesting. This is the piece he's actually making. This was the first one. I was not happy with this ring because the diamonds are coming out too much. So I told him to make the diamonds a little bit down. So you see the difference? It is 0.3, 0.4 millimeters, not more. But this is, in my opinion, much more beautiful than this.
Really?
It's my personal taste.
作为 Picchiotti 的掌门人，如果一个年轻人来到您这儿，他想成为一名出色的定制珠宝设计师，那他应该具备怎么样的能力和潜质？
The most important thing is the training. If one trains with the right masters, those who have a long experience and are capable to pass the knowledge to their pupils will be the best qualified. Of course, a natural talent and a passion for what has to be done are also very important.This was a very, well, this is an extremely very important necklace, over $2 million. And each single ruby is different from the others. There's not one stone which is absolutely identical, impossible. So we put all the width, height, and depth of each single stone. You are not going to change anything. Because if you change something, at the end you will have a very, you will have a very, very hard time.This is just an example, but look at this. This is even worse. You have here 4.63 millimeters, 4.56, 4.60. So we go by...
Not the same size.
Goldsmith has to be very careful, and he has to really look at each single stone in order to be sure that there will be no problem at the end.
皮切奥蒂先生告诉我，一件珠宝首饰若被称为高级定制，那它一定会被注入设计师和制造者的灵魂，因为其诞生的过程非常繁复，大约需要通过20道工序，每道工序都要专门的工匠负责。而从一位学徒成为工匠，往往要数年甚至更长的时间的积累。
This is the so-called stone setting. After we finish the piece of jewelry, we need to set the stones. So these three people actually work all on microscope. Let me show you. This is larger and becomes very thin. So it's graduated. So each single stone, you must touch it and touch it.
Yes, different size.
Yes.
现在每一个行业都在机械化代替手工业，那在珠宝业也是这样。那为什么在这样的情况下 ，Picchiotti 还是要坚持手工制作呢
？The best craftsmanship is achieved with the best artisan, of course, who only not only know that they master the techniques, but they also interpret the design with that human touch that makes the handmade pieces apart from the machine-made ones, taking them.To a higher level, of course.
皮切奥蒂尽其所能地在自己的珠宝工坊里保留着手工打造的传统，因为在他看来，这是赋予每件珠宝不同意义的唯一方法，机器无法替代。
Can I show you one thing? I'm extremely proud of this part of the building, because if you look at it, every single piece is totally handmade. There is no casting here.
Really?
100% handmade.Look, 1, 2, 3, 4 different sizes of balls. We have the flowers here, we have the motif here going around. I mean, it's really, in my opinion, quite a nice piece. I can show you perhaps from this angle.
This is the idea of your diamond.
No,
different size.
Yeah, you're right.
Like the detail.
You're right.You see the holes here?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In order to get the the brilliancy of the diamonds, we must make the holes perfectly clean inside.
Yes.
In order to make them clean, we go the old way, like 2,000 years ago. She will show you what she does. 2,000
years ago.
Yeah.
So actually, this is white before.
Yes. It looks very simple, but it's not terribly simple.
Oh, 真的看起来很简单，但是天，还有一个香料
上上上上上
上。哎，这
you are too young. You are a boy.
How to working?
You're a young boy, so.
Young boy, yeah. 两千年前，咱们就是这么干的。结果已经用了两千年了，才从白的变成黑的。
Tirato,
tira.
Okay.
Yes.
怀着对珠宝工艺的热情，皮切奥蒂和他团队设计出了一件又一件登峰造极的大师作品，他也让几乎被大众遗忘的意大利传统珠宝工艺再次为人瞩目。在这儿，诞生的每一件作品都是一个独特的存在，为佩戴它的女性烙下了美丽的印记。
我是主角，你是谁？
怀抱珠宝设计的梦想，颠覆伊诗家族长久以来的传统，自此展开意大利顶级珠宝工艺的人生之旅。这本身就是一个充满传奇色彩的故事。而如今，皮切奥蒂用一件件精美绝伦的作品向人们展示了他作为珠宝设计师的天赋和才华。但是珠宝绝对不是他世界里的全部。
OK, four, strike.
The villa was built in 1792, 93, 97, I don't know, but it's about 220 years old today. It has about 1,100 trees around, and we have four gates for different entrances. During the summertime, the leaves come down so that you have it practically totally closed around. In my opinion, it's very beautiful. The little wooden hut.Was built in 1999 when my first granddaughter was born. So it's now exactly 16 years old. This is my love. You have a wonderful view from here.
我们都知道皮卡利先生，您对珠宝是处于狂热的热爱状态。那这种状态会影响您的生活吗？您又是怎么样权衡对事业的追求和对家庭的维护呢？
I have never let...My job disturbed my private life. When my children were young and were living at home, I always made sure to spend time with them, with the whole family for vacation, holidays, weekends, and so on. And now that they are grown up, I always make sure to spend some time with my grandchildren and also take them off some time to have some enjoying, hours together.
Wow! That's the granddaughter?
Right, the two granddaughters.
Two granddaughters.
Right, these are four. I have four actually. One, two, three, four.
Okay.
One, two, three, four. Long time ago. Can I show you here, which is a very nice corner? You see the view we have here?
Wow!
That's a paradise.
Yes.
So I was born here and we are extremely lucky to be here, mm-hmm. of course, after so many years. Now the third generation is coming in and I hope that they will continue the business. I'm sure they will because they are very interested actually. Mm-hmm. Ciao Ludovico! Here's the third generation.
Ciao.
Good to see you. Good to see you. Good to see you.
He just came from school.
皮切奥蒂在珠宝工坊创立初期呢，就曾有过这样的一个想法。有一天，他的身边环绕着儿女，全家人一同筑梦，踏实着经营着珠宝事业。而如今，他的梦想成为现实。
我们听说您家里面的家族每一位成员从事的都是和珠宝有关的工作，那情况是这样吗
？Yes, it's very true. I am the founder of the company, and since they are.The very beginning, I always liked the idea that one day I would surround myself with my children and relatives to help me with the business. Today, I am flanked in the managing of the company by Giuseppe, of course, and 7 family members. Each of them are responsible for different aspects of the business and contribute greatly to our success.
和最爱的人一起从事最爱的事业，或许这是最让旁人羡慕的一种境遇。很多事情我们不需要刻意的安排，只是耐心的等待缘分的到来。好比一件定制珠宝拥有者和宝石的美丽邂逅，也好比皮切奥蒂和 Jewelry 的遇见。
那是怎么样的机缘让 Picchiotti 和 Jewelry 走到一起的呢？
Jewelry came to our booth at the Vicenza Fair a few years ago. We soon understood that they could have been a very valid partner for business in China. That's why we have nurtured the relationship and have worked closely with them to further develop the presence of Picchiotti in China with the help of Jewelry, of course.
Jewelry 是源自意大利的高级珠宝定制品牌，它力求将那些默默坚守着家传工艺、极尽绚丽的意大利珠宝带到中国。为此 ，Jewelry 将多家意大利珠宝工坊纳入旗下，并与其设计师和顶级的工匠签订独家合作协议，以保证其珠宝款式和工艺上的独特性。
那在为 Jewelry 设计的各种珠宝产品当中，有没有哪件设计产品是您个人感到非常非常骄傲的？
One of the most important pieces was a beautiful flower brooch with sinuous diamond leaves, featuring a stunning sugarloaf sapphire, unheated sapphire, encircled by rare round emeralds. This piece was clearly one of the most important pieces that we ever did, and the interpretation that we gave to itMeans a lot to me.
时光会改变很多东西，但定制珠宝的独一无二和代代相传的特质，成为我们选择它更富情感的理由。定制早已不是地位和金钱的象征，它更关乎一种情怀，无论对拥有者还是创造者，都是如此。
现在每一个行业都在不停的改变，那您希望在珠宝这个行业，哪些是可以改变的？那哪些您希望是永远不要改变的
？I always aim at the very best, so I always try to take my jewelry to the next higher step, both in terms of craftsmanship and the gemstones that we use. One of the aspects that I would like to keep forever is the special artisanship that is that is passed on through the training of the youngsters. That's why I always try to find young talented men and women who can be trained at our workshop to learn the secrets and the skills of fine jewelry making.
将艺术创作的态度融入到每一款的珠宝当中，我完全被定制珠宝的魅力折服了。所以呢，在下期节目当中，我决定带上果儿，给他一个大大的惊喜。